endearment credits. By the grace of Almighty, all of you are well wherever you are with your nearest and dearest one. I hope you stay home, stay safe, and stay fine. In the COVID-19 pandemic condition, Virtual Cadet College arranges online class. Dear cadets, I welcome you to all today's online class of class 12, chapter 1, name of the chapter, Environmental Chemistry, Chemistry second paper. Dear cadets, look at this picture and think what will be the topics today. Topic of this lecture today, the problem and solution of different gas laws. At the end of this lesson, dear cadets, you will learn solve the problems related to different gas laws, calculate the value of different parameters, determine partial pressure. Dear cadets, today's discussion problems about Boyle's law, Chern's law, different parameters, partial pressure, mole fraction. Key points of this lecture today: volume, pressure, temperature, mole, and ideal gas. Beloved cadets, for solving mathematical problem related different gas laws, we use different units. It may be CCS, it may be MKS or FPS. Here, 1 meter cube equals to 1000 decimeter cube equals to 1000 liter. Again, we know 1 liter equals to 1000 milliliter equals to 1000 centimeter cube. Pressure on atmosphere, 76 centimeter mercury, 760 millimeter mercury, and on 0.325 kilo Pascal. Temperature, there are two units used, STP and ACTP. If STP 0 degree centigrade temperature and ACTP 25 degree centigrade temperature, STP standard temperature and pressure, ACTP standard ambient temperature and pressure. Mole, 1 mole of gas equals to Avogadro's number 6.023 into 10 to the power 23. Again, you know 1 mole of ideal gas equals to 22.4 liter. Dear cadets, in the previous class, we discuss about different gas laws, its definition, explanation, derivation, and curve. Now, in this lecture, we discuss about the mathematical problem related to different gas laws. Now, gradually we discuss one by one. Dear cadets, first one, Boyle's law. We know volume of gas is inversely proportional to the applied pressure on that gas. For two gases A and B, the law is VA PA equals to VB PB. Here, K is constant. There is problem. Here, two gases, three parameters are given. Now, we need to calculate the pressure. The law is for calculating the final pressure, P2 is the final pressure, V on P on by V2. V on initial pressure of that gas, V2 initial volume of that gas. And V2 final volume of that gas. Here, initial pressure 760 millimeter mercury, initial volume 100 milliliter, and the final volume 76 milliliter. So the increasing temperature, total temperature 1000 milliliter mercury. So the increasing temperature, increasing pressure, according to this map, 1000 minus 76 milliliter mercury. So the final result, that means the increasing temperature of this problem, 240 millimeter mercury. Now, next, Charles Law, volume of a definite gas at constant pressure is directly proportional to the temperature, that means Kelvin temperature. For two gases, the law is VA by TA equals to VB by TB. So the problem, there are two gases. Here, temperature fixed at initial condition 27 degree temperature, and volume is given 500 centimeter cube. So we need to calculate the temperature where the volume of gas will be double. So the solution of this math. So the final temperature T2 equals to final volume, double of initial volume into 27, that means 300 Kelvin, then 500 centimeter cube. This is the initial volume. So final temperature 600 Kelvin. So the increasing temperature 600 Kelvin. Now 327 degree centigrade. This is the temperature in where the volume of gas will be double from the initial volume. This is the result of this problem. Now, absolute zero, it is theoretical concept. The condition where the volume of a gas theoretically zero. Where the volume of a gas theoretically zero. This is the equation Vt equals to V naught into 1 plus T by 27.3.15. If you decrease the temperature of the gas, at last you will find volume of a gas is zero. That means minus 273.15 degree Celsius. If you put the value of minus 27.15 degree Celsius, in case of T, in that case, Vt equals to zero. That means absolute zero, minus 273.15. In that temperature, the volume of a gas theoretically zero. Okay, dear cadets, now Avogadro's law. We know at fixed temperature pressure, the volume of gas contain equal number of molecules. All the gases contain equal number of molecules of fixed volume. So for two gases, the law is VA by NA equals to VB by NB. Here, the problem, what is the mass of a sodium atom? We know 1 mole of sodium atom contain Avogadro's number 6.023 into 10 to the power 23. By putting the value of n. By putting the value of n, we'll find the mass of a sodium atom. N 2.3 n 6.02 into 10 to the power 23. So the result is 2.6 into 10 to the power 22. This is the mass of a sodium atom. Ideal gas equation, PV equals to nRT equals W RT by M. Here W is the mass of that gas, M is the molecular mass of that gas, P is the pressure, and V is the volume. Again, D is density, Pm by RT. By applying these three types of equation, we can find the different parameters which are related to this equation. Dear cadets, problem. Here given temperature, pressure, and volume of gas. Now we need to calculate number of molecules. This is the equation, n equals to PV by RT. By putting the value which are given, we find the result. That means the number of mole. We know according to Avogadro's number, 1 mole contains 6.02 into 10 to the power 23. So the final result by comparing the molecules present in this problem, 2.39 into 10 to the power 19 molecules. Dalton's law of partial pressure. Here we know total pressure of the gas present in the system is the summation of the partial pressure of that gas present in the system. If there are three gases or more than three gases, in that case their partial pressure are P1, P2, P3. So the law is total pressure equals to summation of the partial pressure of that gas is present in the system. Here, P1 is the partial pressure, mole fraction, another content. Here, mole of a specific gas divided by the total number of moles present in the system is the mole fraction. This is the partial pressure, mole fraction of that gas, into total pressure of that system. There is a problem. There are two gases. First, gas A, second, gas B. We know for first gas, volume is given, pressure given, temperature given, second gas, volume given, pressure given, temperature given. But temperature different, volume different, pressure different. Now problem one, number of molecules in gas A, we need to determine. Then number two, we need to calculate the total pressure of this gases present in this system. Now problem A, here by applying ideal gas equation, PV equals to nRT, we put the value P, V, R, and T. R is the universal gas constant. Its value is fixed, 0.082 liter atmosphere per Kelvin per mole. Here, temperature 27 degrees Celsius. That means Kelvin scale 3300 degrees Kelvin. Here, temperature 300 Kelvin. Pressure is given, volume given, pressure 300 atmosphere. That means this millimeter mercury unit convert atmospheric unit by dividing 760.
Dear cadets, the value of n here 0.1284 mole. Here 0.0284 mole. We know by comparing Avogadro's number 6.02 into 10 to the power 23, we calculate the number of molecules. Okay, the value is 7.7322 into 10 to the power 20 on. This is the number of molecules present in this gas A. Problem 2, total pressure by applying Dalton's law of partial pressure. Here P on V on P2 V2 final volume, we need to calculate it. P on V on P2 V2 given. P on is the for gas A pressure, V on is the for gas A volume, P2 is the for gas V pressure, V2 is the for gas B volume. This is the V, it is the total volume of gases present in the system. It is 800 plus 500, 1300, or 1300 milliliter. So the total pressure of the mixture 280.77 millimeter mercury. This is the total pressure of the gases present in the system. So today's discussion problem and its solution related with Boyle's law, Charles' law, Avogadro's law, ideal gas equation, Dalton's law of partial pressure. Beloved cadets, if any query, you inform me through online, I will solve it. There is a home task. Cadets, solve 6 problems related to 6 gas laws from each law, you will solve a problem. Dear cadets, always remember the critical condition of our country, also in our beautiful world. So you stay home, stay safe, and stay fine. Thanks a lot.